I thought quite a lot of different things. Like at first, when I was at school, I had thoughts that people were talking bad things about me and stuff like that, and then it kind of developed into different thoughts, and I wasn't, you know, thinking completely freely the whole time. So I was tired for quite a bit of the time because sometimes I wasn't getting very good sleep and my sleep schedule was a bit messed up.
Psychosis is a serious mental illness. It's a group of disorders of things like schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. And our treatments at the moment are trying to help the symptoms of those disorders.
He just was having a few strange experiences. He felt that there were people that were crying in his class at school or in the exams that he was sitting in, and it was just not Ed. And then he became very poorly, and we realised that he needed to go to hospital. But we had a very, very steep learning curve, having had no experience of psychosis. I didn't even know what it was.
So the SINAPPS2 trial is a trial, a double-blind, randomised controlled trial of immune therapies in the treatment of antibody-positive psychosis, people with psychosis with particular anti-neuronal antibodies that we've found in their blood.
What excites me is that it is breaking down the barriers between neurology and psychiatry, the barriers between diseases of the mind and diseases of the body. Here we have a really good example of an immunological mechanism, an antibody, potentially causing something as mysterious as psychosis, and potentially being treated by something as humdrum as what you might get in your regular hospital for a disease like psoriasis or arthritis.
He was offered the option of having a blood test to see whether he had the NMDAR antibodies in his blood. The result came back as a positive. Yes, he definitely has the antibodies. He wanted to do it, and I was really pleased because that was something very positive. At a time when his life had just kind of decelerated, and he really wasn't doing very much at all.
What made me participate in the trial was probably knowing that it could help others as well as, you know, potentially help myself. I like helping other people out, and I think that's probably what motivated me to join the trial.
He wanted to help other people that had the same problem, you know, the same antibody identification. And I just thought it was a lovely reason. For me, I loved the fact that he was involved because it was a focus.
If any psychiatrist sees a patient with psychosis who they think may have one of these antibodies, or does the test and find that they do have one, then please refer to us so we can advise on a local neurologist who understands this condition and understands the trial. But please contact us directly. If someone with a psychosis and these antibodies enters the trial, then what they will have to do is come to the trial centre several times over the course of a year. Initially, quite a few visits where they'll receive the treatment, and then every 3 months, as well as having monthly telephone interviews.
With the treatments, I had to be in all day from the morning until 4 or 5 in the evening. The drugs were administered by infusion through my arm, so they had a cannula in and infused it through that. The staff were really friendly, and it was really a really good experience to have met them.
So the drugs used in this trial are very conventional drugs used to treat a lot of autoimmune diseases. So they are intravenous immunoglobulin given over 2 or 3 days, followed a month later by 2 shots of rituximab. So what's innovative about this trial is that it's people with psychosis and these antibodies, but the drugs that we're using are very conventional and routine drugs in the treatment of any autoimmune disease.
I must admit to being a little bit apprehensive about the idea of having, for Ed, having an infusion. I was reassured by the fact that rituximab and IVIG are both drugs that are used for other medical conditions, that they weren't totally new drugs. They're well known, and I think that was very reassuring. Obviously, if it's a completely new drug, I would be feeling, or I would have been feeling a little bit more anxious.
It's very important that people with psychosis on this trial understand that all of their normal care continues. They're free to contact their mental health team and their psychiatrist to adjust the doses of the drugs that they're taking, including to withdraw them if necessary. So all that will continue, and the trial visits and the trial treatments are on top of their usual psychiatric care.
Being in the study period for the 6 to 12 months was quite good because it helped me focus on whether I was getting better, and even though if you had the placebo, you were still being checked on after those 6 to 12 months and being progressing and in analysing where your mental health is at. There were more people that were making sure that I was okay and progressing.
It's been a positive psychological experience for him, regardless of whether physiologically he's actually had the drug as well. There's absolutely no regrets. If Ed's had the placebo, as a parent I would do it again. Because the whole package was a very good experience, and it was just very reassuring, very nice people that we've been involved with, and I'm just very grateful for that.
In my life, things have changed quite a bit since I've had the treatment. I've been more outgoing as a person, more talkative, less tired than I was before, and a bit more focused on what I've been doing.
So people with psychosis may well come into this trial wanting to be helped themselves, and we understand that. But above all things, they will be helping people in the future by taking part in a definitive study which tells us whether this treatment works or not.
As a family, we do have hope for the future, and we do we can't control what will happen, but we do feel very positive that Ed's future is going to be a success.
We are recruiting from most of England and now from Scotland as well, and every psychiatrist who is seeing people with psychosis can make them aware of this study and recruit people into our screening study to see if they might be eligible for the trial.
Please sign up, because the collective effect is going to help all of us who've been in this situation, you know, and all of those who are yet to experience psychosis in their family situation. The more of us that can be involved, the better for all of us.
I suspect this is just the beginning of a new adventure for neurologists into the world of psychiatry.